Okay, so I got to the hospital at 5:30 a.m. And I checked in at the front. And then they took me in the back here. My boyfriend's still out there. They said they'll call him back here in an hour because I'm actually checking in 2 hours before surgery. The surgery is at 7:30. So now I'm in this little room. They made me change into this gown and this cap. And I had to pee in a cup. And yeah. So now I'm just waiting, and they gave me these little sockies. Yeah, I'll show you. And there we go. They gave me these sockies, and this gown is like way too big. And this is my room. Oh. Yeah. So now I'm just waiting. I don't know. I'm scared. So it took me forever to get out of the hospital because the medicine, I kept falling asleep and it just was hurting so much. And now I just got to my boyfriend's house and I'm just here. It just hurts to breathe, like it's still bleeding. That's why I have this cough. But whenever I breathe through my nose, it's like a sharp pain because I'm on oxycodone, but it just hurts a lot. So, yeah, I'm about to eat some grits and stuff. It's like 2, 3 p.m., something like that. So, even though I got with surgery, got done with it like 11 or 12, I'm just now getting home. They had to wheel me in a wheelchair out to the car and shit, so. Hey guys, so I'm like wearing this gauze now constantly because I wasn't bleeding at the hospital and I just was like sleeping a bit, and then I wasn't bleeding when I got home here to my boyfriend's house. I was fine, and then I took a nap and I was sitting upright, I wasn't even laying down. But then I started bleeding so much, and like you could see, they're just soaked through. Like, this is like my fifth gauze within like, I don't know, 3 hours or something. Like, it wasn't bleeding at all at first, and now it just started bleeding so much. I don't know why, but yeah, I'm just chilling over here, and I'm just editing my videos, of course, with all you guys. There's some tea I'm gonna watch though, and some grits, because I had required some grits in the boyfriend meeting for me. And yeah, I'm just chilling. I'm just always. Hey guys, this is day two. I don't want to show you my bloody nose. Like, I'm feeling okay now. It's not bleeding anymore, but I bled like all over the pillow. I had to wash it. But I just want to say that this fucking anesthesia hurts so much. Like, my neck hurts, my shoulders hurt, my back hurts, my abs hurt, just like I did a workout yesterday or something like that. And I read up on it, and it was like, basically, it's you get sore muscles because you're laying on like the hard surgery table and. Yeah. Oh my god, I'm starting to bleed again. Fuck, I'm so tired of this. But yeah, that's why, everything hurts from anesthesia. Just like my whole body, it just feels like I've been fucking working out all day yesterday or something. I don't know. Just not fun. And it keeps bleeding. And today I'm supposed to, like yesterday, okay, I got this stuff. I had my boyfriend go get it for me. Where did it go? Let me go get it. It's like the spray, because I had called the doctor and I was like, why am I bleeding? Because I was bleeding for like 8 hours straight. And so one of the residents told me there's all my drops in there, a bag of them. And then they told me to get this Afrin, and it's a decongestant, so to put a lot in my nostrils and like just hold them so they would stop bleeding. So I did that, it didn't really help. I had to do it like 3 times. It finally kind of subsided, but I still bled through the night. Like, yeah, and then today I'm starting to do antibiotics. I think it's amoxicillin as well as prednisone, which I was on before. That's supposed to like shrink the polyps. And I'm supposed to do the saline solution sprays and also saline solution rinses. So I gotta do all of that shit. Yeah. Okay, so this is the end of day two, and as you can see, I don't have my nose hammock on anymore. It's not bleeding as much. It still bleeds sometimes, but I mean, it's given because I was operated on all four sinuses, so that's a lot of blood. And what I'm doing now for post care is I have this handy dandy thing, this box of saline solution. You mix it and you do rinses like 2 to 4 times a day. You gotta rinse your nose out from all the blood that can be congealed because you don't want that drying up inside of you, because then it'll be harder to remove. And also to keep your nose moist inside because it's very dry once they scrape all the mucus lining off. And I'm also doing a nasal saline spray every 2 hours. And that's different because it stays in there. The one that I just showed you, that flushes everything out, so it's different. And then I'm taking prednisone, which is for inflammation that I used to take before, for like 4 days. And then, or no, I don't know, it's like 3 days, 4 days, three each, and then 3 days, two each, and 2 days, one each, or something like that. And then I'm also taking amoxicillin, which is antibiotics, so you don't get infections. And then I also have hydrocodone for pain, but I'm not on pain meds today. I just took them yesterday, but today I'm fine, so it doesn't hurt. The only thing that hurts is like my whole body, my neck feels like I had whiplash, my back, my abs hurt. I don't know why. My arms, everything except my legs. Like my shoulders hurt. It just feels like I ran a marathon yesterday and did some workouts and stuff like that. But yeah, I know I look like a mess, but it's okay. Because I just had surgery, so whatevs. But yeah, I'm about to just do a mask on my face really quick and call it a night. Just relax and stuff. I took a week off work, so yeah. And now it's still hard to breathe because there's all the blood inside. So before I had polyps, I couldn't breathe. Now I have blood, I can't breathe. So it's like, what's better? But I mean, obviously, I'll be able to breathe soon, so I can't wait. So it's day three after my surgery. It's Friday now. I had it on Wednesday, so 2 days, 3 days after it. And the bleeding kind of subsided. It still comes and goes, but I also forgot to mention yesterday my throat hurt a lot besides the rest of my body because they put the tube down your throat. So every time I swallowed, it hurts a lot. But I'm okay now. It's just I'm aching everywhere and my nose keeps bleeding. I can't breathe through my nose right now because there's so much blood in there. So I have to breathe through my mouth, but I'll be okay. Oh, I also forgot to mention that for some reason, when I rub my eye right here, it hurts underneath. Not this one, just the right one. But I mean, they told me that I've got like packing inside right here in my sinuses that's dissolvable, so it's gonna dissolve on its own in like a week or two. And maybe that's why I'm thinking, but it just hurts when I rub this eye, like all under here hurts. But not this one. It's so weird, but hopefully it goes away. But I'm just really thankful that nothing happened because I was so scared that I'm gonna like either go blind or my brain is gonna start leaking out of my nose. Like, I was so scared, but it's all good. I'm gonna be fine. Oh, so all I have to do now is the post care, like the rinses and the spray and like a billion different medications. But other than that, if I take care of myself, then I'll recover well. So. Okay, new day, new updates. So today's Saturday. I had my surgery Wednesday morning, so it's Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So it's like 4 days now, and the aches all over my body have worn off by now. So it's just 48 hours that lasts for. And I totally forgot I had a sticker right here from nausea. From anesthesia, you get nauseous and you may vomit. So I just took that off today. I totally forgot it, even though I showered and everything like that before. But the good news is that I can smell again, kind of like not the way I used to smell. It's gonna come back, but they told me it might take like a few weeks, few months maybe. And it's been 4 days and I can smell like only stuff, it's it, only if it's really potent, like if it's gasoline or like creams that I'm putting right here on my face, like chapstick that's right near my nose, or if it's really potent like gasoline or something like that, like this thing that I'm sitting on. But not everything I can't smell, but I'm so excited I can at least smell something now. That's a big progress, so that's good. I'm so glad I did that surgery, like so glad. And what else was I gonna mention? Oh, now that I'm not bleeding anymore, I'm still doing the rinses and the medication, but I can notice that now that I stopped bleeding, I noticed once the blood here is like not all over my nose,
I see that they ripped my nostrils because, hey, I'm doing a vlog about my surgery.
On the ATV?
Yeah.
Alright, well, dinner's ready.
Wanna come say hi? I'm talking about how I think they ripped my nostrils. You can see it right here, look. You see right here? And on this side, because that's why I was bleeding so much. Because even that girl at the office, she was like, I don't know how they're going to shove that camera and the tube up there, up your nose, because you have really small nose, like my nostrils. And I think they, like, you can see the scabs, like, they ripped it in a couple of places, like, both of them. Fuck. Yeah. Okay. And I forgot to mention, like, we took a little trip for the weekend to North Carolina, and I had to bring this whole thing of distilled water with me. It's pretty heavy, but it's because you need to do your rinses for the sinuses, and it has to be distilled water. So I have to tuck this thing around with me. That's the sealing packets for it. And I have, like, all my medication over here. I don't want to, like, show you my info on it, but yeah. And I'm about to just go to the beach, but I'm feeling pretty good, like, only thing is I have to keep up with my medication and my rinses and all that stuff. So, yeah.
Oh, also, I don't know if I mentioned this or not the other days, because I was so, like, fucked up out of it. I don't remember if I said this. But you're not allowed to blow your nose for till you see the doctor, which for me is 2 weeks. It's a little long. Some people, it's like 1 week. They have to follow up, but I have 2 weeks. So it's kind of hard, but, you know, because you have all that blood in there and you want to breathe and stuff, but you're not allowed to blow your nose. Like, don't.
Little update from the beach that I forgot to mention earlier. I'm having a lot of post-nasal drip, and it's kind of gross, but, like, I had some before my surgery, so it's not like I'm not used to it, but it's still gross. So, but it's, like, a lot yesterday and today. And today's day, but I have surgery Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Today's day 5, so, yeah.
So, it's Monday, and it's been, what, like, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, 6 days. I still have this bruise on my fucking arm, like, from the IV. What the fuck?
Okay, quick little update. I'm, like, at the Charlotte airport right now. I'm going to Vegas, but this is day 7 for my surgery, and it's Tuesday, today, and I just wanted to say that yesterday and the day before, like, a lot of blood has been coming out whenever I did those sinus rinses. Like, yesterday, it felt like literally, like, it was so gross. Like, if you've ever seen Prometheus, you know, the scene that she's giving birth to the alien, that's what I felt like. I was giving birth to an alien baby in my fucking nose. Like, it was so much stuff. You know, it was disgusting. It was, like, it made me gag. It was so gross. And it's still doing it. And I don't have the water with me. Like, it has to be distilled water. So I don't know if I'm going to do the rinses. Like, on the way there, I'm gonna have to buy some, like, something there. I don't know, like, call the hotel desk, like, maybe some distilled water. I don't know, but yeah, just saying. Out of nowhere, I just started doing that. I was weird. Hey guys, quick little update on my surgery. So today is Friday. I just got back from Vegas. I'm in Virginia now, and I'm doing good. Like, the flying did not bother me at all. I thought it was going to bother me with the pressure and everything like that. Like, I'm doing fine. Like, it's just that the blood is still coming out. Like, every time I do the rinses, there's more blood. And I'm like, dude, like, how much am I going to be bleeding? Like, Monday is my checkup, my follow-up. So it's going to be 2 weeks on Monday, like, since my surgery, or actually Wednesday. Yeah, because I had surgery on Wednesday. But, like, you know, it's been a week and a half, and I'm like, what the fuck? Like, why am I still bleeding? Like, and it's, like, dark, dark blood. It's, like, congealed, and it's gross. Like, it's just, like, thick, and I don't know. It's gross. But, like, it's just still coming out. And I'm like, what the fuck? Like, how much more am I going to be bleeding? It just will not stop. So every time I do these rinses, like, it just keeps coming out. I'm like, yo, this shit needs to stop. But other than that, I'm doing good. I'm still taking my medications, my prednisone, my amoxicillin. I'm still taking my montelukast and desloratadine and everything like that, and I'm doing good. Like, I haven't had any complications or anything like that, but it just sucks that I can't blow my nose. That's the only thing that's kind of annoying. Like, and it hurts a little bit. Like, if I breathe in really, like, deeply, it kind of hurts. It, like, pulls on something inside, I feel like. I don't know. But yeah, Monday's my checkup, so hopefully it'll turn out good. He's supposed to, like, rinse everything out in there. Like, I don't know. It's going to be kind of scary, but we'll see.
Yeah, I know this is fucking gross, but this shit is still coming out. It's been, like, almost 2 weeks, and I'm still bleeding, and it's, like, all this stuff. Just, I'm over it. Like, the fuck. Hey guys, I'm on my way to my post-op appointment for my surgery right now. It's been like almost 2 weeks. It's Monday. Wednesday's gonna be 2 weeks that since I've had it, and like seriously, it's been such an improvement. I can actually breathe now, and I can fucking smell and taste. And honestly, like I'm a little bit like disappointed that they haven't given me the right diagnosis before, because I've been going to these doctors for legit 10 years since I was 14. I'm 24 now. And they could never give me the right, you know, diagnosis. Like, they were just, oh, you have allergies, and here's some tablets to take and sprays to fucking spray and all this shit, you know. If they would have just told me that I had polyps a long, long time ago, like, sent me for a CT scan, I would have, like, gotten the surgery fucking years ago, you know what I mean? So it just kind of pisses me off a little bit. Like, yeah, I'm good now, but, like, not that I'm being ungrateful, but at the same time, it's like, what the fuck, you know? Like, I could have, you know, had this relief a long, long, long time ago. Like, I haven't even sneezed. I'm, like, so surprised. What is this fucking phone doing? Like, I haven't even sneezed since my surgery, which is surprising. It's just so different for me. Like, it's a whole new life, because I normally sneeze all the time. Like, I even if I take medications, I still have allergies. It relieves it some, but, like, I still would sneeze for everything, like dust, pollen, cats, everything. Like, I'm just allergic to life. And I haven't even sneezed, so I'm just like, dude, this is such a relief, you know? Like, it's been helping me a lot. Oh, my God, this fucking GPS is stupid. It keeps fucking with my screen. But, yeah, that happens. Hey, guys, like, I just got done with my appointment, literally. I'm like, I almost want to cry. Like, it was so uncomfortable / painful. Like, not even just, I'd rather it be like just painful, you know, straight up, and then be over. But it's like a weirdly weird and uncomfortable feeling, because he had to like suck all of the stuff out, and not just out of your nose, like out of all of your sinuses. So he shoved this thing up there, and literally I felt like it was going inside my whole head, like, because it goes all up in here, up in there, like all in deep in there, and just like takes out all the like blood and crusts and like this, not the stitches, but like the packing, the dissolvable packing. He took some of that out, and it just felt so uncomfortable. It almost passed out, because like he said, it's normal, because when you mess inside of your sinuses, you're messing with the vagus nerve, and if you do that, then it's very easy for you to start passing out. So almost dead. Like, I started seeing stars and all the shit. My blood pressure dropped. Like, it was not fun. Like, and it still feels so uncomfortable, and they numbed me, but it still doesn't do shit. Like, so my whole mouth is still numb, like my teeth, it feels weird, but it still hurts, so it's weird. Like, that shit was not pleasant. Like, no, I mean, just, I don't know, I'd rather like it hurt, you know, for a bit and just stop, then like be this, because it's like, it's not feel good. I feel like I just got hit in the face with a truck or something, like, for real. Hey guys, I just have my appointment, my second post-op with my doctor, and I have one more left. This one was not actually hurting as much. Like, it didn't even hurt, honestly, at all. Last time I remember, it was so bad. Like, I came home afterwards and I just like laid in bed, like I tried to nap and sleep it off, but I didn't, it just was not good at all. It hurt this time, and they do numb you, by the way. I don't know if I said it the last time I filmed, but they do numb you before. It just still hurt a lot. I don't know if it, like, because this time they numbed me too, but this time he actually suctioned it out instead of poking with the stick back there into my face, so I think maybe that's the difference. But this one didn't hurt, like, at all. I am numb, like my throat and my nose and everything like that, but this one didn't hurt, so that's good, you know. I have a list because of my fucking Invisalign, but yeah, that's the update. And I'm still bleeding when I, you know, blow my nose or whatever, do my rinses. I'm still bleeding, so I'm still not recovered all the way. And today's the 4th, so on the 9th, it'll be a month, because that's when I had my surgery. It was July 9th. So it's been almost a month and it's still bleeding. And yeah, I don't know. That kind of sucks, but whatever. Hey guys, little update. So I just went to my third post-op appointment and I told him that I had this like green discharge for the last maybe like 5 days, and he looked inside. You know, he was supposed to clean it anyway. So he looked inside and he said that it's an infection on both sides, and they prescribed me some like antibiotics. There's actually topical cream that I have to put inside my rinse. So that's going to be annoying because now I'm rinsing with 3 things every day. So yeah, but hopefully it goes away and they are sending a sample to the lab and they'll get results in 5 days. He thinks it might be staph, but he doesn't know. So they're going to send a sample to the lab, and when they know what it is, then tell me. And you know, maybe if it's something else, I'll take a different medication. So yeah. Hey guys, I wanted to do a quick update on my surgery. I just had a phone call from my doctor. So remember how I said that I had the infection going on, and they sent it to a lab and they gave me some antibiotic cream that I added to my daily rinse for it, but they weren't sure what it was. He said it might be staph. So now that I got the results, it's actually 2 bacteria. So it's staph and E. coli. Like, what the fuck? So I have that in my nose. It doesn't feel like anything weird or anything. I just have like green discharge or whatever when I blow my nose or like do the runs and stuff. But other than that, I don't feel weird. But they prescribed me some medicine that they sent to my CVS. I'm going to go pick that up. And it's pills that I have to take twice a day for 3 weeks. I'm going to take that in addition to my rinses that I'm still doing. So yeah, we'll see how that goes. A little update on the antibiotics. They're making me sick if I'm taking them on an empty stomach, which it's supposed to be on an empty stomach anyway. It says right here, which by the way, it's doxycycline, hyclate, whatever. It says take this drug 2 hours before or 2 hours after antacids, iron, vitamins, minerals. Take medication on an empty stomach 1 hour before, 2-3 hours after a meal. So like, it's so hard to remember already to take it every 12 hours. But on top of that, like on an empty stomach, you know, it's so hard. And somebody told me to just to eat some crackers in the morning before I take it when I wake up, because it literally made me sick. Like I threw up from it. It's really harsh in your stomach. So I don't know how I'm gonna get through like 3 weeks of this shit, but it's not fun. So, but I gotta take this, and this is supposed to be for both the staph and the E. coli infection. So yeah.
Hey guys, I wanted to give you my final update for my surgery, and that will be the end of this vlog. And if you want to know more about like how it all came about, what nasal polyps are, my previous history with like asthma and allergies, just go to my main channel where I will be putting up a video all about that. But this was kind of my story, you know, so that way I don't forget how I feel, because you know, it's October now, I had my surgery in July, so of course, if I do that video now for my main channel, I would have forgotten, you know, that I felt so bad after the surgery. Like, I was editing the footage today, and it was so crazy, like, you know, that I felt bad after the anesthesia, I forgot about that. All the, you know, antibiotics I had to take, all the names, like, of course, I forgot. So, it was a nice thing for me to do, to see how I went through this whole thing. So, I'm glad that I did this vlog, but basically, that is it. I've finished my antibiotics now and I'm feeling good. Everything's fine. I do have another follow-up this month with the doctor, with the surgeon. So he will, you know, examine me, make sure everything's fine. But I feel fine now. I'm still doing my rinses with the saline solution and the budesonide. But other than that, I'm pretty good. And I'm so glad I did the surgery. My sense of smell is back and everything's great. So I would definitely recommend it to anyone that's having the same problem. And yeah, so don't forget to go subscribe to my other channel and check out that video. I will link it in the info box below for you guys. And I'll see you next time. Bye.